So I saw this article the other day, and obviously when I saw it, I was none too pleased. But I've had a few days to digest it, think about it a little bit. So I decided to do this video because I need to talk about this. I really do as a gamer. Marketers experiment with TV ads and console video games. Players are used to watching ads in exchange for rewards on mobile and social games. Will they tolerate them on a console? To me, the answer is no, but let's continue. Marketers are putting TV ads and video games played on consoles, an experiment in trying to reach younger audiences who are watching ever less traditional TV. Because we know we've been cutting the cords and going to more streaming, but also services like YouTube TV and the like. So, obviously, we know what the real issue here is. It's money. It always is. So, for example, they ran ad tests within UFC 3, a fighting game from EA. What a surprise. This is Electronic Arts, them of the very dubious reputation in video game circles. So, promoting Turner properties, Rick and Morty, Snowpiercer match, it doesn't really matter. That stuff doesn't really matter. Our experiment, we don't care about that sort of thing. That's not what's important here. What's important here is the takes behind them. Starting with this guy right here, Steve Hartman, VP of Integrated Marketing at Experian. The way people are consuming media these days, you don't reach 100% of your audience on TV anymore. He's not wrong there. That's why this is even being brought up. So, in exchange for watching 15 or 30 second commercials, which is optional, okay, that's a key right there. Players don't have to watch them. Gamers receive points or other rewards they can use for in-game benefits, making the ads less intrusive, says Dave Morgan. Okay, let's stop you right there. Now, we're aware of this. If you have any mobile apps and any mobile games and stuff, especially free ones, you've seen ads everywhere. And they are, you can use them to get rewards and stuff. I've seen it before. I've seen many. Now, I don't do them. I ignore them. I ignore them by the plague. But I've seen them several times, as we all know, as everybody knows, anybody who's ever had mobile gaming knows. It does make the ads less intrusive, that is correct. However, let's take a step back and realize something here. Whenever something like this has come up for the sake of money, regardless of what the situation is, these things aren't always optional. What I'm afraid of most, which I think will actually happen, you give someone an inch, they'll take a mile. You've heard that saying before? So I feel like if they start pulling this stuff on, say, consoles, at some point, they're not going to be optional. I feel like they're going to start making them compulsory. And possibly even worse, they'll start trying to draw revenue from the fact that people will try ignoring the ads. If you've ever seen on mobile games before, there are offers there where you could pay like $3 or whatever and get rid of all the ads for good. Or you join a premium club and pay a couple bucks here and there. I'm afraid that that would end up happening. I'm almost certain that it would end up happening. You can call me a conspiracy theorist or whatever you will, or think I'm overthinking this stuff, but to me, I don't think this is out of the realm of possibility here. And that I will take exception to. And I can already see right now that if they try putting that on consoles, could you imagine having a game, a $60 title, and now there's a $75 title with no ads on it? I can see that happening. Well, let's continue on. EA Sports declined comment. I wonder why. So other console makers runs over tests, adding game owners will get most of the ad revenue. Okay. Rewards-based video ads are common in mobile and social media games. I've said that before. But they've been largely absent from console games played on TV screens, the canvas that marketers typically envision as they and their ad agencies create 30-second spots. Activision Blizzard Inc., for example, runs full screen video ads within Candy Crush Saga, Farm Hero Saga, Call of Duty mobile games, but doesn't do it on console games. Okay, it's important here to point out a false equivalency that this article is making. I'm not going to accuse, for once, I'm actually not going to try accusing the mainstream media of misleading people, but there is a false equivalency here. Social media games and mobile games, sure, there are some that you have to buy, I believe, but the large portion of them are free. They're free. It's no different than what we used to do back in the day. If you wanted to play online, you go on a game site and you could play a bunch of flash games and stuff for free. That's the point here. Console games are not free. No. They are not free. As such, the revenue comes from different sources. When you have a free software, it's not free to run it. It's free to us as a consumer, but it's not free to them. They have to patch it. They have to they have to update it. They have to do all this stuff behind the scenes. There's costs associated with that. So ads and microtransactions are the two ways they can get around that. So it's a big difference when you're talking about a free game where this mode of revenue stream is much more prevalent than this part right here. To me, that is something that needs to be emphasized here. When ads have appeared in console games, they have more often shown up in virtual billboards and other signs within the game world. That is true. NBA console games, for example, feature signs and our branding in their virtual arenas. So you'll see things such as graphics and stuff. I remember Madden games having Snickers showing up for the coin toss and things like that. So yes, they are correct. Product placement has been around. It's a little different though. For one thing, it's not an advertisement, okay? It's not. Well, it is advertising technically, but it's not a 15 to 30 second spot. It's just there and then poof, gone. You don't even give it a second thought because it's not actually interrupting much of anything. In fact, I'd argue it really is not ruining anything. If you do a 15 to 30 second spot, say right before a final boss, you're ruining the immersion of the game for a gamer. That is much more important than what they're doing here. Once again, confusing multiple things. Advertising is beginning to creep into consoles in other ways. If an industry shift towards downloading, streaming games over the internet instead of using physical discs, such as Fortnite. Okay. I've never played Fortnite. I never play, Overwatch or any of those games, so I can't tell you. But I am definitely sure that is the truth here, as if you go on Twitch or whatever, you gotta deal with a bunch of advertisements and the like. So yes. And it's not really a surprise. I mean, I can talk about this, but honestly, it doesn't surprise me that they're looking to video games because if you think about it, video games from a pure entertainment standpoint is actually a very young industry compared to other forms of entertainment we enjoy. Movies, for example, have been around a lot longer. And before then, it was theater. Television's been around a lot longer. The radio's been around a hell of a lot longer. And let's not forget sports have been around since the what, BC days or very early AD days? I mean, so it's not a surprise that all of those examples I mentioned have advertisements, have commercials, have all this stuff going on. It's not a surprise that now video games are being touched now because they haven't been, because they've been so young. I think that is the biggest reason for it. So I'm not surprised that's actually happening this way, but I'm not a fan of it. Gamers are notorious for hollering at changes they don't like, such as this video right here. And they have not been exactly clamoring for ads since inside games that often cost around $60. Correct. Online games are free. I mentioned, okay, I'll give them credit for actually mentioning that here. With publishers making money by selling virtual goods or rewards. Hardcore gamers, if they are used to paying 60 plus for a video game, they may not feel aligned with an ad support experience, said John Frelinghuysen. I think that's how you pronounce it. My apologies if I didn't. I'm sure I didn't. Managing director of consulting firm LEK Consulting. I don't know why I'm having trouble reading, which has researched the subject of ads and games. But as you move down to mid-core casual level gamers playing free games or games on sub-services, we think the market's much more ready for that. I think he's absolutely correct here. What, as I mentioned before, mobile games and stuff, the market's definitely been much more ready for that. And I think there are people out there who will use the opportunity, because I've seen how shameless these things are and how these microtransactions work. I've seen how shameless they get. Oh, you failed. Now you have to wait 40 minutes, or you can do this and get another play. Seriously. So when you talk about people like that, I think it's much different than talking about people who are paying 60 plus for a video game. But it doesn't even end at the 60 plus for a video game, guys. If you have a membership, like an Xbox, Xbox Live back in the day, or a PlayStation Plus or whatever, you're looking at what? 20 bucks to get 20 bucks or 10 bucks a month or something like that? I don't know. I haven't gotten a membership in an extremely long time since I haven't been a console gamer for a very long time. That I think that also adds to it. And let's not forget DLCs. Some games out there are notoriously brutal with DLCs, giving you as much as hundreds of dollars worth of downloadable content if you wish to buy it. So you put that on top of that, and then you put advertisements in on there. That just seems like a really bad idea. That's going to make people furious. Now, let's take a step back and realize something else here. There's one thing here that's not being talked about when they talk about console games. That's the master race, as I've heard some people call it. PC gaming, Steam and the like. Steam, what's the UBS one? It's called Ubisoft. It's the Ubisoft one. I forget what it's called. I can't type either, apparently. It's like Ubi Plays or something like that. I forget. I'll look for it right now. It's Uplay. Thank you very much, people, and I'll let you click the right thing here. Okay. It's Uplay. So with those options on the table, people could easily just go to those and play, $20 games, $30 games, $10 games, etc., etc. So if they even went the console route, I think it would actually hurt the consoles more than help. Executives have acknowledged in the test, acknowledging the risk of alienating gamers, correct, but they've shown a willingness to accept ads in exchange for rewards. Executives also don't realize what they're talking about here. Once again, like Mr. Frelinghuysen has said, you move down toward mid-core and casual level gamers. I think that's where you got to look into. People will accept ads in exchange for rewards. I think the executives are correct in that. Like I mentioned, especially in mobile games, where the stuff is free and you really don't have as much of an investment. But also anything that's notorious in microtransactions, such as, for example, probably the most mainstream hardcore version I can think of is your like Madden Ultimate Team, where you can pay money to get packs to get that diamond player or whatever that has like a 95 rating that'll help your team when you play online. And if you haven't noticed, or if you don't play those type of games, I'll tell you, EA makes a killing off that. They make a killing off the Ultimate Team that they kind of ignored other modes like franchise mode and like. So I haven't gotten a Madden game in so many years, guys. Because, that's not for me. So I don't think they're wrong when they say that, but I think it's important to us as gamers if we want to keep ads off of console games, we have to make a stand here and say no, we aren't accepting this. Now, some more hardcore gamers I think will be pretty adamant that no, this ain't good, but I'm more worried about the AAA the mainstream gamers that play like Madden and the like. I'm more worried about that because I don't know. I used to be that type of gamer, but I'm not anymore. I haven't played those type of games in a very long time. I'm afraid that maybe some of them would actually do that in exchange for maybe getting a say a free card or a free player or whatever. But I don't know. But I think it's important that everybody has to stand up and say, no, that's the only way you keep consoles free from advertisers. Now, they can say whatever they want here that if they're going to service type content, they're not going to push dog food. It doesn't, it's actually kind of they hopefully care about. That's not the point. That's not the point here. The point is that you're tainting the gaming experience. That's the problem here. I don't care if you're pushing dog food or you're pushing filet mignon. If you're ruining the experience, you're ruining the experience, okay? That's the key here. Okay? That is the key here. I don't care how eloquent or how pretty you dress it up. It's still bullshit at the end of the day. It's a very disingenuous statement, in my opinion. So that's kind of where this ends right now. The most fundamental piece here is we have to create an ad experience that gamers accept. Maybe they won't love it, but at least they say, yeah, for a couple points or bell shield, I'll watch the ad. This is where I think we have to actually make that statement and say, no, I'm not going to add to my self-interest. It might, I know for some people it might actually be more painful, or some people may not care as much. But in this case, I think we have to actually, as a community, get together and say no. You want an ad experience that we'll accept? Here is our terms. No ads. That's it. I wouldn't even go that. I would say that's the bottom line right there. The only other way I would even consider entertaining something like that, and I really don't care, you make a bunch of, if not all, DLCs free, or you slash $60 game tags to $20, kind of like ESPN sports games back in the mid 2000s used to do, when they were trying to compete with Madden and EA Sports and like. But I think we'd have to say no. We'd have to say screw them. I really don't want to see advertisements because I have a feeling they would actually ruin the immersion badly. I really do. I don't know how. It doesn't explain how they're looking to go about doing it. I think that actually does matter a little bit. But I'm not going to play a game for an hour, see an advertisement, or a half hour, see an advertisement in the middle of it. That is not going to help. That to me is garbage. I think it is a terrible idea, and I think that from a gaming experience, it's terrible in general. Especially when you consider the fact we've already sunk enough money to getting a freaking console, getting these games, getting the DLCs in some cases, and going down that road. Not to mention that there are alternates out there, such as Steam. You can go and get a gaming computer and not have to worry about that stuff, and still play the games, a lot of the games that maybe aren't exclusive to PS4 and like. It's and to those people out there wondering if maybe that's not a great alternative, I think it is. I think it is. I did it for a very long time. I did it for an extremely long time. I was Before I got my PS4 last year, I subsisted off of PC gaming for several years exclusively. So it can be done. It can be done. My reasons were completely different. My reasons for getting a PS4, I'm not going to go into, but I assure you it does not detract any of my argument at all. It really doesn't. So some people want to call me a hypocrite on this sort of thing. I really don't care. My reasons for doing that are not really relevant to what's being told here. So anyway, just to conclude, I'm not surprised that they're actually looking into this. I feel like it's kind of overdue, to be honest. But I think if we're going to keep marketers out of console games, we have to let them know that this is not acceptable. We spent too much money on this stuff, and I'm not looking to have my video game experience ruined by a stupid ass ad or five. I don't care. And the rewards that they give you, these little cookies, those aren't going to be enough. Those aren't enough. Those aren't good enough. I'm a little afraid that there are going to be a lot of people out there who could possibly do that. But I think it's important to note that even if it does, it would have to be self-contained. Like I mentioned the Madden example with the Madden Ultimate Team. But I think it would be best for everybody to just simply say no, absolutely, positively not. And not even leave them a single shred of doubt, a little opening that they could take. Because, like I said before, it's optional now, but may not be later. You give people, like marketers, an inch, and they will take a mile. Because whenever money's involved, people will find a way. You can't let that happen. That's all. See ya.